Hey, what's going on, everybody? Hope everybody's having a good weekend so far that just started. I just wanted to give a little introduction to the video you're about to watch. For those of you who watched my last video, you know that I'm doing a psychology project. And it's a group project, and my part of the group project, I got hypnosis, which is awesome because I immediately thought of the TV and why I haven't owned one in 2 years. And I made a video according to that. Be able to play this in front of the psychology class, so 30 or 40 people that aren't exposed to this type of material are gonna be able to see it. So I use some of the classic stuff, as far as clips, but I also put some music. I just assembled this whole thing just to kind of portray a point. But of course, it's protected by fair use. It's not for sales, for educational purposes. And the software I'm using is not fancy. It's Windows Movie Maker, so there's really not a whole lot you can do. You got to kind of be creative in order to make the audio levels work when you're dealing with clips that you're using that already have a predetermined maximum audio level. I can't really do anything with that, so some of these audio levels are not the best, but I did the best I could. But nonetheless, I think it drives home the point, and I look forward to watching people watch this. But I just thought I'd let y'all check it out too. It's probably not anything new to most of you, but I think it's still entertaining, and I spent quite a bit of time on it because I enjoy doing this thing, and I wanted to portray this point to people that may not hear this type of thing. So hope y'all enjoy. Let me know what you think. It's not set in stone, so if I notice something, I might end up changing a little bit. But yeah, enjoy. Peace.
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
All these people are currently living through the most technologically advanced era since yesterday. Today everyone's obsessed with gadgetry and machines that light up and go pippy pippy pat pat pip. We spend more time gazing at luminous screens than into the eyes of our loved ones. Gadgetry has become so commonplace we consider it part of nature itself. Which is more technologically advanced, an iPhone or a cat?
Definitely a cat.
That's a ridiculous answer. But recently, machinery has become so advanced it's downright terrifying. How did we get this messed up? Maybe things started going wrong when we first surrendered our attention to this flickering meddler.
Television is a massive, massive, mass hypnotist to the global mind. And what happens is it is implanting a belief in reality by the minute, and then once we take on that belief implanted, when information enters the eyes, we edit it on the basis of that belief. And so what the global population is subjected to, suffering from, is actually literally mass hypnosis. And when we talk about people who kind of start to see things and see the manipulation they couldn't see before, what do we say about them? What do they say about themselves? They say, I woke up. Exactly what they've done. When people start to go, hey, I can see it now, it's like someone has gone along, like the hypnotist, and clicked their fingers, and it's like, oh, I can see it now. Mass hypnosis. And that is the greatest hypnotist on the planet, and that's the basis of why it was created.
What has that got to do with the price of rice, right? And why is that woe to us? Because you people and 62 million other Americans are listening to me right now. Because less than 3% of you people read books. Because less than 15% of you read newspapers. Because the only truth you know is what you get over this tube. Right now, there is a whole, an entire generation that never knew anything that didn't come out of this tube. This tube is the gospel, the ultimate revelation.
Get a book, man. Reading is fundamental. Fundamental. It ain't illegal yet, but they working on it.
I'd say that television is by far the most powerful weapon of psychological warfare in history. And I consider that so important. And yet, many people, if not most, don't think of television in those terms as a weapon.
How people think of television as simply an elective choice in terms of entertainment and information, when in point of fact, the television is the boss.
Yes, and it's illustrating how we are taught what's right and wrong, what's acceptable and unacceptable behavior to storytelling. Storytelling is the oldest means of transmitting information about how society works. There isn't much difference between primitive man sitting fixated in front of the flickering light of a campfire, telling stories about how things work, transmitting information from one generation to the next. Not much difference between that and modern man sitting fixated in front of the flickering light of a television, receiving information, the same kind of information, how society works, what's acceptable and unacceptable behavior, what's right and wrong. The first order of business for a propagandist or an advertiser is to create the circumstances that are going to induce a state of mind that is most favorable to the reception of their message. That state of mind is the hypnotic state of mind. The state of mind, natural, we go in and out of it throughout the day. It's a twilight state of mind in which there is no conscious mental activity going on. The mind is a blank slate, and it is the state of mind where we are highly suggestible, and we can even catch ourselves when we're in front of a TV going into that state of losing all sense of time and place. We're simply there. We're soaking up information like a sponge. The television is literally plugging into our nervous system. It's a literal interfacing of the electronic media with our nervous system. Back in the late 1990s, 700 children had to be hospitalized in response to watching a TV cartoon. This happened in Japan.
Japan, yep, I remember.
The cartoon was the highly popular
Pokemon.
The press all over the world reported on this incident. Well, what happened was that strobing flashes of light pulsated from the eyes of one of the cartoon characters, and this caused epileptic-like seizures.
Talk show host Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be able to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on his late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night TV.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope once again on late night TV.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien is looking to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night TV.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may
be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be about to push the envelope on late night television.
Conan O'Brien may be preparing to push the late night envelope.
It's called television programming. They telling you visually to program. You're being programmed. You watch it on the news. It was on CNN. It's true. I seen it on Fox. It's real. It's bullshit.